Oh my god.
This is forever, bro. Hey, what's up, Fishing Freaks? How you guys doing today on this wonderful, wonderful Saturday afternoon? And what better time, what better thing you can do on a wonderful Saturday like this is pop the rod and go fishing. But today, for the first time on Tactical Fishing, we have the box that's on all the channels, but now it's on Tactical Fishing. Welcome to the Mystery Tackle Box. So, I'm gonna open her up and see what we got. Alrighty, first MTB box on Tactical Fishing, and let's see what it do. Voila! Woo! It says unfold here, so we're gonna unfold it. Got some cool little stuff here, some cool little fishing pointers, and how big the bass thing is. Got some little cool stuff here. Some wowie wowies. Got some of that good stuff here. All right. Dibs. Bass tips for mystery tackle box. All right. First of all, we got some hooks. Daichi World Sharp hooks. Nice. And what I've been using, what I've been trying to target anyway, we got the Deep Diver. I mean, this is really deep. Look at that thing. Sweet. We'll be throwing that Deep Diving crankbait. This is by Carl's Amazing Bait and Tackle Shiver Crank. And we got some stuff that to go ground and pound with. We got the 10X Tough Ela Z-Tech. And we are going to do something with that. Oh! We got the Eno Jig Mollux. I'm gonna hook that up with this nice combo. And we got the Xcito bait. This will work nice out here. Something for the fish to chomp on a little bit. And I got something for this. I'm putting on the open odd hook. Put that on there. And we got some other pointers, add to your box, follow-ups, you know. So if you want to hook up with Bait Carl and Tackle, you know, you can sign up and get your box every month. And we got the sticker. We got a nice little sticker here. That's so sweet. And we got the welcome. Mystery Tackle Box. And that is all that's in the box today. So, if you want to get a discount on a box, I got a hookup. I can pass the hookup along. It's called Geet. G-E-E-T. Put that in. Mystery Tackle Box. I mean, all this stuff is worth like 30 bucks. I mean, I shop for this stuff. Stuff like worth 30 bucks. You can get it on the low. At Geet, G-E-E-T, get your hook up. But you know what we're about to do. We are about to do some fishing. We're about to hook up with some major hookup-ish. So I'll see you on the field. Hey, what's up, Fishing Freaks? A different camera angle. I just wanted to switch things up a little bit. But
ready for this MTB box. And first choice that I'm going to throw out here, this is a little time spender, little spot that I can spend a little bit of time in working the MTB box. This is Griffith Lake in Charlotte, North Carolina. And I'm ready to pop them. Let's get it popping. We'll start off with the deep diver. We'll go do some deep action. Let's go. But with the deep diver, it's pretty simple. I mean, basically you just reel this in and it has some great action in the background. And also it goes pretty deep. With this muddy coverage, this will work good. Oh, this doesn't show up on. Okay, it doesn't. This will work good with this muddy water today. Because all the rain and all that good stuff muddied up all this stuff. So, let's get it popping. One more cast with this deep diver. What I'm doing is trying to work some space with the space I do have in this area. Going to move right along to throw in, what we're going to do, let's do some jig action. All right, and also I want to mention there is some other helpful videos. A guy who I grew up watching a whole lot in the fishing in my early days of fishing is Gene Jensen, Fluke Master. So check him out, and I'll leave his link right there. So check him out, man. If you want to know how to operate a bank, use flipping jigs or swim baits, anything, check out my boy Gene Jensen, Fluke Master. So we're gonna work this crawl looking bait, this bug looking thing. Just let it sink to the bottom, give it some pops. Let it work itself. Hit that bottom, pop it. Let's see how it looks. What I do is just let it sink all the way to the bottom and just give it two pops, let it sit for about 4 seconds. Some more pops, let it sit for about 4 seconds. Just let it simmer on down. Let it simmer on down. And just give it two light pops. Just let it sit. Just two light pops. Pop it real light, just barely move it. Two light pops, let it sit for about 4 seconds. Pop. All right, that was stuck. I'm trying to get this some good arm, but we are limited with the amount of brush. There we go, that's the good one. Good caster. Sink on to the bottom. I'm using the jig with that little creature bait on the back. But we're gonna move into a little different spot after we work this. See what we can pop out of here today. Next, we're gonna throw this swim bait. Nice little swim bait. Now it's with a 2-aught hook. And you can buy these weights at a Walmart. They're about, I think, $4? Bass Pro Shops. You can buy these little weights on attached to it, save some dough. But I've been pretty successful with the swim bait out here. So we can do today. I like to work this, give it three pops, let it sit 4 seconds. 1, 2, 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds. 1, 2. And I just reel that on in. 1, 2, 3. Reel. 1, 2. Reel. 1, 2, 3. I just kind of pop it on in when I'm close to that bank. All right, let me see. That's a cast. That's what I needed. I'll let that bait just drop on down. Let that bait sink on down to the bottom. Yipperoo. And that started popping. All right. Try to, I'm gonna get one more sling. I gotta catch me some fish, man. Come on. It's like playing the slots at the casino. You don't know what's gonna happen. What's gonna hit, when it's gonna hit, or how it's gonna hit. You just throw what these fish like. And if they like it, they hit it. Simple. That's fishing. The fish like it, they hit it. All right. We're going to move on to something a little better. All right. I got some strikes in this other section. Let's see what we can pop over here. See what we can get. Over this way. Let's see. It has a little bit of opening over here. I'm not going to use the deep diver. I am going to use the digger. See what we can. Let me see. Let me float this. Do some pitching. Come here. Let's see what's over here. Nobody home. Let's do another pitch. Come here, buddy. And drop. Let's see what's over here. This light ain't got enough space. Pop it over this little thing right there. Like a little, what you call it? Okay, I ain't got nothing over here. Let me try to throw where that tree is. me switch it up. Throw something different. Let me throw some throw some fish action. See what we can get. Looks pretty good as far as bait goes. Let me pitch one more. Trying to move somewhere else. Let me try over here in these weeds a little bit. Let's see what's over here.
Oh, no light. Hey, what's up, fishing freaks? Just got in, gonna work on editing this video for today. Today was a no-go. But see, in the fishing world, when it's in other areas of professionalism, whether it be business or anything else, what we do, we get a hit or if things don't quite go as well, we replan it. That means this is a good day. That means we have to try new tactics. So when a day goes, when you get a goose egg, really that's a win in bass fishing. That's the only place I know of where you can have no they're like no tangible results, but really they're results because you can switch up the game and go out and go big or go home the next time. So, until next time, remember, keep it popping.